Okay, hi guys, so before we get into today's video, I just wanted to give you an overlook view of the zoo so you know what we're doing, since we're in episode 15, I believe, and we're building randomly in the zoo because when I get a good idea, I build it. So I thought I'd give you a quick overlook view of the zoo. So obviously the beginning would be tortoise habitat, which we built. Then if you go to the right, we have our giant bug home made of glass, which I'm actually still kind of proud of. Next to that, we have a gharial habitats, which they're all very happy in. Then I had something that I initially wanted for the P files, but I already placed them somewhere else, so I'm not quite sure what to do with this, but we'll see. Maybe flamingos, I'm not sure. So if we backtrack a little bit, we have this lovely waterfall which leads to the pygmy hippo habitat. You can see them running around there. Then here we have the little feature. And behind here, we have space for another habitat. Not quite sure what, but we do have space. Here, we are going into a little food court where you have a view of the other habitats. Then we have one night house. And a second night house, which I absolutely love. We have some open spaces here. And then here, we have our peafowl habitat, which, to be honest, is one of my favorite habitats. I mean, look how pretty the foliage is in here. I absolutely love it. And look at that view. Amazing. So we have the peafowl habitat, then we have a little bridge. And then we go to Monkey Island, which are the lemurs, and we have that here, so Lemur Island. Which actually, with the boat ride, you get a lovely view of it. Then we have our red panda habitat. Next to that, we have our hyenas. This is still open space, not quite sure what to do with this. Then here we have our gorilla. You can see them climbing there. And then on the other side, we have this pathway leading up to a monorail, which I'm not going to show you guys yet because it's not done. And then you look out on our jaguar. You can, oh, that's a keeper. They were here somewhere. Oh, look, they're in the water. There they are. Then we follow the pathway. You have a lovely view of the gorilla. And then we have our gharial, dwarf caiman. There are a lot. I mean, a lot. Also, there are currently no guests in the zoo, so don't worry. Then, lovely foliage. I'm sorry. We have a little food court here, and then we have our little dinner place where you can eat and have a view of this magnificent waterfall. Yeah, we're just gonna go back to the peafowl habitat now because we missed something. Boat ride, obviously. Food court, which I'm probably going to rebuild because I don't like the way this looks. Then we have our black bear habitat here. You go up the stairs. There will be another monorail station here. Up the stairs, across this lovely waterfall. I mean, look, waterfall. And then we go into this area, which isn't quite mapped out yet. I have some pathways. Not a lot, but I have some. I was thinking of maybe doing a monorail station there again. And then we go to the build for today, which you saw in the cinematics, and that is the Bengal tiger, and they are here somewhere, I believe. Somewhere here. So, guys, that's the zoo for now. We still have a lot of empty spaces. I mean, if we zoom out on the overlook map, I mean, look, we have filled up this part completely, this a little bit. Here we are starting here. We are gonna make something here yet, and as always, guys, if you have any ideas, do let me know in the comments down below, and then we are going to go right into the speed build of today's habitat, which is the Bengal tiger. Let's go. Hello guys, so we are back with the actual video now. You just obviously you just saw a bit of the overlook of the zoo, and now we are back with creating our Bengal tiger habitat. I have to say, I had this habitat in mind since I started this zoo, and it's the exact same spot. I was building the entire terrain, you know, doing the map, doing all the rocks and the vegetation and the water areas. And this spot, it just yelled tiger to me. I don't know why, but, you know, it just does. The way that it lays next to the water, and then when you have the boat, it just goes around. It's lovely, and you have these absolutely amazing viewing spots. At least I think they're pretty amazing. And I will be adding probably some other viewing spots when we are building more in this zoo. Because obviously, I'm not quite sure what other animals I will place here and where they will be placed and how the habitats will look. You know, all that sort of things. So, but most likely there will be added a few more viewing spots, which is kind of logical because we had this entire area on the left side of the viewing platform. You have this little bit of a flat ridge. And you know, there could be a very good viewing spot there. Or there could be a monorail station. I'm not quite sure. We'll see. I don't want to, like, I've been talking about this monorail, I mean, I think forever. I'm not quite sure, but in my mind, like, it's always there and I have this amazing idea. Oh, look, that platform, that one there. So I have this amazing idea to just do the monorail station the entire way, like around the entire zoo. And the monorail will probably be one of the last episodes, just because I don't want to build the entire monorail before I have finished all the habitats and the exhibits. You know, for the very logical reason, I don't want to miss anything. And I'm afraid that if I build it now, the entire monorail station, you won't get to see every animal. And I actually really like the idea of seeing every animal, or, you know, as much as possible with the monorail. So we'll do that later. Right now, we are focusing on our Bengal tiger habitat. And I quite like the way this habitat ends up looking. It is quite different than I initially thought in my head, but I still like it. Especially with the bodies of water. Initially, I wanted to connect it, but you can't, which, you know, kind of sucks. And I was too afraid to delete all the water in the big, you know, very big pond. And I was just like, yeah. Or the lake, like, I'm not going to do that because then I might not get it back. So out of fear for that, we are just putting down some rocks. I mean, from that side, it looks pretty much like it's connected, like it flows in between the rocks. And that's fine as well. Like, it doesn't need to be perfect, even though perfection is something I usually strive to. It doesn't need, like, not everything needs to be perfect, which is very difficult for me to accept. But we're working on that and we're doing pretty okay. You know, that's the most important thing. On a other note, I am feeling better now. Last week I was feeling a bit sick. Now I'm not, so that's good. And so we are now making this video, and I think I missed two uploads now of my Red Tail Zoo, which I hate. I hate missing uploads. I hate, like, I feel like I promise that I make uploads and then I don't, and that really sucks. So, you know, just, I'm sorry. But, you know, like, my health is it's more important than a YouTube channel. So, you know. So right now we are building this little bridge with all these different planks, and the tigers can actually walk over that. So that's pretty cool. I wasn't sure that they were able to, but luckily they are. You can see it there. You see they can walk over it. So yay. And actually, I feel like it's really nice. They have this really amazing body of water, and then they have more water and this little waterfall, and it comes together actually really nice. They don't have such an amazing sleeping quarters, like their shelter is underneath the second viewing point. You can see the wood panels that are just stacked together, and in there there's this shelter, but at least they have some privacy, and I do think that's quite important. And also there's another shelter near the big waterfall. But that's a little bit difficult to see. That was something I did struggle with during this entire build. The lightning. Oh my gosh. I mean, it is built. I believe right now it's like 3 p.m. in my game. And I couldn't get the right lighting for ever. It was so annoying. There's always this big shadow on this habitat. And it was so annoying. And I can't help that. Mainly because there is this big giant mountain right next to the habitat. Like, on both sides there's a mountain, and on the left side it's a little bit bigger than on the right, but there are still like mountains there, and it just casts a shade on the entire habitat, which is really, really freaking annoying. So sometimes it was a little bit of a guessing game where I actually play something, and luckily if you press L on your keyboard you get the like a flashlight. And that helps, I have to say. Like, it helps a little bit. Like, the light that we have right now is the best light I could find. And that says something, because there are a lot of shadows. Like, a lot. But you know what? It is what it is. It's fine. We've managed. We've survived. And it's all good. And I feel like that's actually pretty darn important. Also, today, maybe this voiceover sounds a little bit weird, but today is one of the, like, one of the few episodes where I voice over when other people are actually around. So, it's really, really weird for me to, you know, record a video while other people are listening to me recording videos. Hopefully, you know, when I get my own place, well, not hopefully, I know that when I get my own place and I can finally move into my new home, I won't have this problem. Because, you know, it will be my home, my rules, and I can be as loud as I want without disrespecting the neighbors, of course, because, you know, they're my neighbors and you gotta be kind of respectful for that. Also, I'm gonna do this house tour when I'm all said and done, which will probably be in, well, July, so 4 months away. But you can prepare yourself for that, be excited, because it's going to be amazing. And it is, I don't want to say my new home is a fixer-upper, but it needs some work. So I'm going to do that. And it's going to be totally amazing. And I can't wait for you guys to see it. But again, I can't show you guys now anyway. So no use that. But once it's done, I'm going to create a video on my channel. And I hope that you guys enjoyed it. Like, I have no clue if you guys want to see that. And even if you don't, I'm probably still going to make it because, you know, I want to share my new home with you guys and I'm so proud of it. So I want to be able to see and let the world see that I can live a good adult life. But I should probably get back to the video. So right now we are making a ramp for the tigers to go onto. And they can climb it. I've checked that. I wasn't quite sure. Because I wasn't sure if they like would climb it or walk on it as well, but they can walk on it, so that's pretty good. And then obviously we are going to put some foliage on there. I like to call myself the queen of the foliage. And to be honest, if you see my P-file video, you will see why. And if you haven't watched that yet, why not? It was really good. Go watch it. It is linked in the playlist at the end of this video, so you know you definitely should. Because it is quite amazing. My foliage work is on point. And there are a lot of things that I'm not that good at this game, but foliage is one of my things that I excel in. And I think that everyone can confirm that. I have faith in that, I believe in that. So here we are working with terrain paint. I am working with terrain paint more. And more often than not, it looks actually kind of good. At least I think so, because, you know, otherwise the entire map would be green with some rocky areas and that would be kind of boring, so obviously you don't want that. So we're putting some soil in there, sometimes a little bit of sand, some rock work around the rocks that we already have, and I actually feel that it looks quite nice, it looks quite natural. And I'm really happy with the way it turned out. And to be quite honest, I don't really remember anything more that happens in this video, because when I was building this habitat, I wasn't still feeling very well, so I don't really remember a lot of what I built. So it is kind of a surprise for me as well. I'm looking at this and I'm like, oh yes, but what was I doing after that? Ah, apparently I was putting ivy in the middle of the sleeping area, which makes sense. Oh, well, roll out, it actually makes sense, because otherwise you had these bare walls and I don't want that. You know, you're gonna need something anyway. So let's put ivy there. That's kind of a recurring theme in our zoo. We're putting ivy on things. I love ivy. Like, since I've discovered that, I love it. And even though I don't think ivy is very common in tropical biomes, I've never been in a tropical biome, but whenever I watch it on TV, you know, like Bear Grylls survival or something, I don't really see a lot of ivy, so I'm not quite sure. Maybe I should have used vines, maybe that was a little bit better, but whatever. Also, I think that we are like the halfway point at the moment of this zoo. I'm not quite sure, but I think we're there. I think. I hope, to be honest. Otherwise, I would be kind of devastated. And, you know, well, not devastated, but then we'd be like, wow, there is going to be so many things that I need to do, and I have so many ideas for this zoo, but I also have a lot of ideas for already other zoos, so. But don't worry, before the zoo ends, like, I'm gonna let you guys know, and there will be an entire episode of finishing up, and there will be some good tips in there as well. I think I might do that a real time episode, but again, I'm not sure. Just I'm rambling on, I don't even know what I'm saying. But if you have any ideas for like habitats or animals, or you know, built in general, or perhaps you are like, you know what, I don't really like a tropical zoo, but you should build something in the tundra biome or temperate, or build something in South America, I don't know, like whatever you think of, you can leave it in the comments down below and I will get back to you. Same if you have like amazing ideas for just builds, like, oh, you could build a tiger habitat including like this, or ooh, remember the scene from this movie, what if you built that? That's all fine, like, leave a comment down below. I always reply, I like replying to you guys, and I always do something with it. And also, if you're watching this and you haven't been subscribed yet to my channel, what's wrong with you? Why aren't you subscribed? I mean, are you not entertained? Because obviously you are, because you have been watching this for almost 17 minutes. So you are clearly entertained. Otherwise, you would have turned the video off by now. So, click subscribe. Like, it doesn't cost you anything. It's free. So just do that. And it helps the channel grow. It helps me out, like, honestly, a lot. We are at almost 150 subs at the moment, and I'm really excited. And for all you guys that are, you know, faithful viewers and watching every single thing I upload, thank you guys so much. I really appreciate it. It has been almost a year after I started on YouTube, and I started with The Sims 4. Don't upload that anymore because people weren't watching, but people are watching my Planet Zoo stuff, and I really enjoy sharing this with you guys. So again, if you have anything you'd be like, oh, this would be so cool, if you need tips or tricks, let me know in the comments down below and I will get back to you. For now guys, that's it. I will leave you with a few final frames of this habitat building, and then we will go into the cinematics. Do stay tuned for that because they are lovely and we all love tigers. So stay tuned for that guys, and I wish you a very good afternoon, morning or evening wherever you are in this world, and I will hope to see you on the next episode. Bye guys.